Discussion is on a visit to Cambridge, poem When I Set Out for Lyoness. About the author, this poem is written by Thomas Hardy, who was born on June 2, 1840 in a village of Upper Bockhampton located in southwestern England. His father was a stone mansion and a violinist. His mother enjoyed reading and relating all the folk songs and legends of the region. Between his parents, Hardy gained all the interest that would appear in his novels and his own life. His love for architecture and music, his interest in the lifestyle of the country folk, and his passion for all sorts of literature. The work of the English novelist, poet, and dramatist Thomas Hardy unite the Victorian century 1840 to 1900 and modern eras. They reveal him to be a kind and gentle man, terribly aware of the pain human beings suffer in their struggle for life. Introduction. The poem When I Set Out for Lyoness is about the poet's journey to an imaginary country named of Lyoness and his transformation after returning back. In order to understand the poem, we must first understand its background. It is believed that Lyoness was a country that, according to Arthurian legend, King Arthur was near Cornwall, a country near England, before sinking beneath the sea. Hence, the poet imagines going to that city. The poet, who was an architect, went to supervise the construction of a church in Cornwall. There he met Emma, who later on became his wife. Thus, the whole poem describes how the poet felt after meeting her. The poem is divided into three stanzas. Summary. First stanza. In the first stanza, the poet says that when he set out for Lyoness, Cornwall in Trial, which was 100 miles away, there was rime, frost, that is small ice crystals on the spray. The line gives an insight into the climate. It was winter season and thus chilling cold was everywhere. In poetry, winter symbolizes doom or sorrow or darkness, hence the poet seems to be hopeless. He feels lonely and the starlight, twinkling star, in his only hope. According to him, the twinkling starlight take away his loneliness. The poet repeats the first two lines of the stanza. According to him, all this happened when he set out for Lyoness, which was 100 miles away from his home. The first stanza symbolizes hopelessness and a quest of something. Stanza second. In the second stanza, the poet wonders what would by chance happen at Lyoness when he will sojourn, stay temporary there. The line depicts that the poet is quite curious and excited about the visit. He feels like neither the prophet, here it means priest, can trust or declare, dare to tell, nor the wisest witch, future teller, can guess. Again, the first two lines of the stanza are repeated. According to him, he doesn't know what will happen at Lyoness when he will stay there. The second stanza describes the poet's curiosity. He is thinking that something great and memorable will happen at Lyoness. Stanza third. In the third stanza, the poet returns from Lyoness. He does not tell what exactly happened there. However, according to him, when he returned from Lyoness, all the people marked that there was a magic in his eyes. That is, his eyes were shining. They found the radiance in his eyes is rare and phantomless. Thus, the poet seems to have achieved something which he was questing for. His hope is fulfilled. He was gotten something that has transformed him. It was Emma, his soon-to-be wife. Again, the poet repeats the first two lines of the stanza. According to him, all this happened when he returned back from Lyoness with a magic in his eyes. Important question. What does Lyoness refer to? Why does the poet use this name instead of the real one? Lyoness is a mythological place in Arthurian legend. The poet uses this place as a setting of his poem to create an air of magic. The poem is written on the experience of the poet's journey to a church near Cornwall. This experience remains as an important event in the memory of the poet. Hence, Lyoness is used as a land of bliss and perfect happiness. Question 2. What were the changes in the poet in his journey to Lyoness? After visiting the place, the poet became happy and glad. This journey had changed his life completely. His heart was filled with inestimable joy, and there was a reflection of heavenly bliss in his eyes. Such gifts were totally unexpected to the poet. Question 3. What are the stages mentioned in the poet's journey to lioness, and what are they? There are 3 stages mentioned in the poem. The poem is about poet's trip to a church near Cornwall. It is actually a description of the development of the poet's state of mind. These 3 phases are before his journey, his staying at the place, and his journey back home. Question 4. What did the speaker say about a prophet or a wizard? The poet said that the prophet could hardly say about what would happen to him at Lyoness. Even the wisest magician had not the power to guess the incident that brought a drastic change in the life of the poet. Thank you.